How will I know if that needs to be replaced? Will the furnace just not work?
Your furnace will not work.
Okay. Okay, I love when my dad's in town because he's going to do a quick check of my furnace.
We know that yours is in pretty good shape because you've had a local service company at 1 hour.
Right.
service it and take care of the routine maintenance. First thing we're going to do is turn the power off. Sometimes it's in unlikely places, but it's over here. That actually shuts the furnace off there. Yeah. Two common tools, a 5/16 nut driver and a 1/4 inch nut driver. We'll take apart most anything on this furnace. So on this particular furnace, we've got two screws holding the panel on, and in the center, you can see it's just a knockout there, keeping the blower compartment. Okay, so here we are. This is the inside of just a basic 80% efficient furnace. We've talked before about inducer assemblies. This is a little fan blower that is actually creates a draft through the heat exchanger of the furnace and sends it up the flue. Now, a lot of people mistake this for a power venter or something like this. This does not create a draft in the flue or anything. It's simply pulling flue gases out of the heat exchanger of the furnace in here. One is cleaning the interior, and as you can see, it's in pretty good shape. You know, that we've had it serviced already. I kind of like just a wet wipe, and you can wipe all the dust and things like that off of it. It sure looks nice.
Why do you want to clean the dust out?
Dust can actually create a problem when it comes to our flame sensors, things like that, you know. So we just, keeping it clean is a good practice.
Okay.
Some many times a washer and dryer, things like that, you know, it's a very kind of dusty, linty kind of place.
Mm-hmm.
First, we're going to look at the igniter here, and we just simply have a little Moloch plug in. Take our 5/16 nut driver. So just one screw. This is our silicon nitride igniter. These are extremely good igniters. Used to be, you know, a decade ago, it was so common to replace these igniters. 2 years would be phenomenal. There were some brands and types of igniters you almost had to replace them every year.
Hmm.
And as you can see, this thing sticks down in the actual flame of the burner, so you can see a little bit of discoloration. I'm not touching anything. We don't want the oils off our fingers or to get on it. Showing a little signs of wear, and what we do to check these is we actually ohm them out. We check the resistance, and so we're gonna turn on my little multimeter. I know this is beyond what a typical homeowner is gonna do, but we're just gonna check it out. And we're running 46.7 ohms. So we're just measuring the resistance, the condition of the igniter. Here is a brand new one. Again, you don't want to touch anything on the igniter, but you can see the difference. So you can see it's been used, but it's still in really pretty good shape. So let's just check the resistance of a brand new one. Do it the same way. Nearly identical. These really don't, the silicon nitride igniters don't really show us much fall off as far as the condition of it, the older igniters would do. But what we're going to do is, this is really in pretty good shape. It checks out very close to the same, and we'll have the new one here on hand in case we ever need it. So to put it back in, being very gentle, goes in here like so. And then we plug it back in. This is high voltage There's only one way for the plug to go back together. There we go. Locks into place. Okay, so that's the igniter. That's what actually lights the natural gas.
How will I know if that needs to be replaced? Will the furnace just not work?
Your furnace will not work.
Okay.
And now the flame sensor. The flame sensor is a probe that actually uses flame rectification to prove whether the burner is lit or not. And it actually will, the amount of current that's jumping through the flame and onto the, from the burner onto this sensor is gonna tell the furnace whether there is a proper flame or not. And as you can see, this one's being cleaned up. See how shiny it is? It's almost shinier than a new one. These you can just scrape off with a knife. Here's the brand new one to be compared to. As you can see, it looks extremely nice. So they did a good job getting that cleaned up. So we're just gonna put it right back. Okay, so we've got the power back on. We have a thermostat calling for heat, but it's in a delay right now. When it does come on, what's gonna happen is you're gonna see this inducer assembly come on first. And if you had the doors covering all this up, you could still listen for what a typical cycle is going to be like. And so the first thing on almost all furnaces is the inducer is going to come on. After a slight delay, and the furnace senses whether it's on, proves that it's on, it has a pressure switch here that's going to prove that it's on, it will then turn on the igniter. The igniter will glow white hot, and so many times you can even see that happening with the cover on the furnace, you know, just through the louvers. But you're gonna see that igniter glow white hot for a period of time, and then it's gonna turn the gas on, and then that flame sensor is gonna then sense that the flame's lit, and it's gonna hold it all on. It's all gonna keep on running. The igniter will then go out. Okay, so that noise there, that's this inducer assembly coming on. It's the first thing that comes on. Now down here, that's that igniter glowing white hot. And it's measuring all this as far as how long it stays on. Then lights the main burner and the igniter goes out. So now it's just spontaneous combustion. But the blower on this furnace we run continuously. Typically there's a slight delay now waiting for the blower to come on, then the blower comes on. That's it. See, if we were to do something like turn the gas off, we've now just lost our flame signal to the furnace. It's now even turning the inducer off and back on again. So it's sensing a problem right now. As you can see, it just started the igniter again. So it just lit the igniter again. Right back through it again.
You turn the gas back on?
I turn the gas back on.
Interesting. Yep.
That's all there is to it. Everything's in good shape.
Okay. Thanks, Dad.
We've not done a full tune-up here. We've not checked the heat exchanger, you know. We've not pulled the blower out, you know. We're just really kind of wanting to look at the top side of the furnace.
Thank you.
There we go.